Sly winks, flirty winks, dirty winks.
But only one sassy wink.
Wink the sassy one from Canada Dry.
It's sassier than ever. So sassy fresh, it sparkles with bright, lively flavor. There's no diet taste, because Wink's no diet drink. Come on, get sassy.
Wink, the sassy one from Canada Dry.
This program was recorded. Speaking. Join us again tomorrow, for love is a many splendored thing. Stay tuned for The Guiding Light, next on most of these CBS stations.
Where the good times are, CBS.
Dick Van Dyke returns to television with a great new comedy series, co-starring Hope Lang, this fall on CBS.
Drive a new Datsun today with your small car expert, your Southern California Datsun dealer.
Oh, for crying out loud.
It's a bigger bottle.
Fashions provided by Banff Knitwear. Stay tuned for The Secret Storm, next on most of these CBS stations. This program was recorded.
Time in the roaring 20s with Dean Jones, Art Matrano, and the Chicago Teddy Bears. View this fall on CBS.
Big Blue, the SOS soap pad. Seems you fellas sort of skimmed over this pan.
Hey!
What?
We cleaned okay, didn't we?
Yeah, he's sure brassy.
Oh, no, I'm steel wool and soap. Nothing cleans and shines pots and pans quite like steel wool and soap.
Whoops. Wow, it's clean and shiny.
Hey, this could wipe us out.
Gee, that should have been my line.
Be sure to watch The Secret Storm every day, Monday through Friday, and stay tuned for The Edge of Night. Next, over most of these CBS stations, this program was recorded.
William Conrad stars as Cannon, a super sleuth. New this fall on CBS.
Tune in again tomorrow for The Edge of Night. This portion of The Edge of Night has been brought to you by Lava, the soap that gets kids' hands clean the first time. tuned for Gomer Pyle next on most of these CBS stations. This is Harry Kramer inviting you to join us each weekday afternoon for The Edge of Night.
She's a kooky charmer. She's Sandy Duncan as Funny Face.
Yeah, it's me.
New this fall on CBS.
You to win a Honda? Whatchamacallit? Oh, you can call it a snowmobile. Or a dune buggy. A trail bike. A rock hound. Or a water bug. It's Honda's new ATC-90. And you can win it. There's no purchase necessary. Just look for the Diet Right display at your local grocer's now.
Diet Right Cola tastes so good. Even skinny people like it. You don't have to give up good taste to save on calories. Diet Right Cola has only half the calories of regular cola, but it tastes so good, even skinny people like it. Dieters think it's pretty good, too.
Be sure to watch Love of Life tomorrow and every day, Monday through Friday. Stay tuned for Where the Heart Is, next on most of these CBS stations. This program was recorded.
Van Dyke returns to television with a great new comedy series, co-starring Hope Lang, this fall on CBS.
By Richard Frontman. Join us again tomorrow for another half hour of drama on As the World Turns.
Recorded. Join us again tomorrow, for love is a many splendid thing. Stay tuned for The Guiding Light, next on most of these CBS stations.
Starring in their first television series, singing and swinging in an hour filled with favorite songs.
Goes down. The beat goes boom, boom.
Plus special guests and lots of clowning between Sonny and Cher.
Well, they said that I sing like a frog.
Poke your heart out, Froggy.
Enjoy it all with Sonny and Cher here on CBS. Sundays at 8:30, 7:30 Central. This is CBS.
Ah, W.C. Fritos here. I recall a time I single-handedly subdued the meanest man alive. A brute named Isidore Fist had the world's largest knuckles. I hit him with a munchy nugget. Fritos brand corn chips. He fell for it. Been pals ever since. You gotta make friends. You gotta have Fritos corn chips.
Acapulco Hots is a new mix that makes a peppery hot chili con queso dip. Boy, it's hot in there.
It's year-end factory closeout at your Los Angeles Orange County Dodge dealers with a mighty mini Dodge Colt, the Dodge Dart Demon, any Dodge, all models. We can meet and beat any deal in town.
Long cigarette, short cigarette. The best is no cigarette. That's the long and short of it.
Wally Cox. Nanette Fabre. Jan Murray. Suzanne Blachette. Vincent Price. Lily Tomlin. Charlie Weaver. Loman and Barkley. Or Paul Lynn. All in the Hollywood Square. And
here is a massive... Kool-Aid lemonade. Kool-Aid lemonade.
sugar sweetened Kool-Aid lemonade with natural lemon flavor.
Not sweet, not sweet as it sounds. Kool-Aid lemonade. Not sweet, not sweet as it sounds. Kool-Aid lemonade.
Sugar sweetened Kool-Aid lemonade mix. It's inexpensive and not as sweet as it sounds.
Ladies, you could buy a ketchup that's difficult to get out of the bottle and spend a lot of time and energy thumping. Or you could buy the kind of ketchup that just seems to gush out. But the smart buy is Hunt's. Thick ketchup in an easy pour bottle. That's why it always pours when you want it, then stays where you pour it. Thick, rich tasting ketchup. Hunt's.
A house or a hound?
Well, I think Ben Franklin would have had fun with it. It would have been a hound.
NBC Week is a pair of high jumpers, a butler and a cook, the men of the Alamo. NBC Week is the partners, high jumpers Don Adams and Rupert Cross. As plainclothesmen in this new series, they'll get their man as soon as they find their plain clothes. The good life. And they weren't always a butler and a cook. But then they found the good life. It's new, and who knows, they just may be onto something. The Alamo, where John Wayne and Richard Widmark hold the fort as this epic drama begins a new season of Saturday Night at the Movies. NBC Week is The Partners, The Good Life, The Alamo. And that's only Saturday.
Hi there. Folks, join us for the premiere of the Sonny and Cher Show this Sunday at 8:30, 7:30 Central Time. I'm going to entertain you with razzle-dazzle display of my all-around talents. Singing, dancing, and comedy. You'll love every minute of it. And maybe Cher will sing a song. For a pleasant hour of viewing, what could be more entertaining than the Sonny and Cher Show?
The Cher Show.
It's not funny.
Neither...
Supposed to ask you what on God's green earth you're doing this morning.
Margaret, flamingo dancing.
No, you mean flamenco dancing.
I mean flamingo dancing. I do it on one leg.
And a pot.
Yeah.
Yeah, very good.
Listen.
You're desperate, aren't you, Ralph?
Listen, this is a genuine... Ginny gave me this just before we went on. She heard me say the other day on the program, I said something nasty about Hollywood pansies, and she said, here is a genuine Hollywood pansy, and there's nothing wrong with it. Isn't it pretty? We've got to have a little talk with Ginny.
Ginny's from New York.
Yeah. Good morning. It's Tuesday, the 3rd of August, and it was on this date Christopher Columbus sailed the ocean blue, beginning his voyage from Palos, Spain to India, and as you may recall, he missed. I don't recall, it was before my time. The provisions of the new welfare reform bill, hammered out by Governor Reagan and a committee of state Senate Democrats, were announced yesterday, and the Senate's going to vote on that bill later this week to find out how it's going to affect welfare recipients and taxpayers. If it passes, we have the former state welfare chief and now special district attorney handling welfare fraud, Mr. Robert Martin, with us this morning to tell us about this reform bill and what it will mean to you and me. There are two openings tonight at the Century Plaza, at least according to Los Angeles Magazine. They put it this way. They said, Lainey Kazan unbuttons mouth and blouse. at the West Side Room tonight. Other pop music openings, Cannonball Adderley at the Troubadour, Young Holt Unlimited at the Lighthouse, Ruth Price at Dante's, and Daddy Cool on the AM program. Daddy Cool used to be what teenagers said to their fathers during the early 1960s, maybe 50s, but no more. Daddy Cool today is an Australian rock and roll group, and they may be to the 70s what the Beatles were to the 60s. We're going to be talking with this group, and they have been promoted and publicized already on this, their first trip to the United States, as one of the great new rock bands. Smokey the Bear, who helps to prevent forest fires, is going to have a companion soon called Woodsy the Owl. Woodsy Owl is designed to get people to give a hoot about pollution. And Glenn Kovar is in charge of the Woodsy Owl Project for the United States Forest Service, and this morning he's going to tell us about Woodsy Owl. Hey, there's a volleyball game at Cal State Long Beach Auditorium tonight. Wilt Chamberlain and Keith Erickson of the Lakers will be playing volleyball, not basketball, volleyball. And they're meeting one of the school's teams in a benefit for the college athletic program. Chamberlain could win very easily at volleyball, as he could dribble right over the net, you know. I mean, he could walk right over it. There are a lot of people who will pay a doctor to help them lose weight. Did you know that in Torrance, California, there is a doctor who pays people to get fat? Dr. George Bray does just that, and why he does and the results of what he's found, we'll find out a little later on our program. Los Angeles theater scene, highly melodic company going on for the month of August at the Amundsen, and a little less time, I think it ends about the middle of August, Knickerbocker Holiday at Dorothy Chandler Pavilion, and Mother Earth orbits into its first full week at the Huntington Hartford. I must get over to see that because people are talking about it. Trial of Catonsville 9 closed Sunday night with a full house and a hung jury.
Has simmered all of us since early last week. Still, a high of 92 degrees is expected in downtown Los Angeles today. Yesterday, it hit 95, matching a 53-year-old record high. In the recreation areas today, the beaches will be mostly sunny, highs in the 70s, water temperature is 72, and the red tide is still with us, too. Mountains expect mostly sunny skies. A few thunder showers are also on tap for the afternoon. Highs in the 80s there. And in the deserts, if you really have to go to the desert, it's going to be very hot. Sunny with afternoon thunder showers, temperatures of 100 to 115 degrees. Oh, you have a note for me there? Thank you. I assume that this is for all of us to hear. From our esteemed general manager, John J. McMahon. Oh, he is so sweet about these. He says, "Dear Miss Edwards, I have had to remind you before about the unladylike lies you were spreading about there being a statue of me in the parking lot. This time I'm wondering why you haven't mentioned the statue of me in the parking lot lately." Well, you see, I do my very best to please these people, and it's impossible. Actually, we were going to mention the statue as soon as we get the initials, which were carved across the chest, sandblasted away. They spelled something that we really can't talk about on the air. Yeah, I better go talk to him about it. See ya.
Where can we get away after the longest day? Touch a star for free, so easily. Something is in the air, pull up an easy chair, leave that turn down day. Come fly away. Our smile can be seconds away from a routine. An adventure.
On Channel 7.
Fantastic stamp offer.
James Stewart, June Ellison, and Barry Sullivan star in Strategic Air Command. See the concluding half tonight on the Channel 7 6 o'clock movie.
That sun is hot already this morning. When I came on the lot this morning, I heard something I haven't heard before. There was a kind of general hum. You may be able to hear it through this microphone. I don't know. A general hum over the entire ABC lot, and I couldn't figure out at first what it was, and then it suddenly struck me. All the air conditioners have been going all night long here, except out on the lawn where it's already pretty hot. And the paper for Tuesday, August 3, Lockheed rescued, Nixon hails action. Bob Banfield has given you that story. Good story over on the left-hand side of the paper about the freaks taking over Wall Street and moving into other mining towns, Ward, Gold Hill, Caribou, Sunset, Chipmunk Gulch, in the spectacular mountains northwest of Denver. It seems that the long-haired kids have all moved into these great old mining camp and mountain towns up in the Sierras and the Rockies. And in some of them, three-fourths of the town's population are these young people. They call themselves freaks, and I guess they're going to make that word into something popular and nicely accepted. But in one of them, a Harvard Medical School graduate, a dropout from a paying practice, provides free medical attention. And all is not love in those communities, however. If you read the article, you find out that they've got all the problems, and they don't have all the solutions any more than anybody else. Then the story at the bottom of the page, L.A. high of 95 matches 53-year-old mark. I think it's going to be that hot again today. And remember, the fire hazard is rising as the humidity drops. As the war goes on, little thing on the second page, as the war goes on many levels, even a beauty queen can be caught in the crossfire. One Arabic newspaper called it inexcusable behavior for Lebanon's newly crowned Miss Universe, Georgina Risk, to have her picture taken with Miss Israel. "Have you no honor whatsoever?" asked the paper. But other Lebanese editorialists rose to her defense. One columnist said, "Have over 20 years of lessons failed to penetrate the layers of mule-headedness and teach the critics that the Arabs are not likely to win the war with Israel by advertising themselves as thick-skulled fanatics?" He's right, you know. The Arab Press Relations Bureau has been bad, bad. Then there are pictures of the Lockheed people on the third page getting the word. Lockheed employees in Burbank break into smiles and cheers on hearing the newscast that the Senate had voted to save Lockheed. Oh, on page 4, fascinating story, the Earth wobbles. You ready for this? And every 7 years, that wobble makes the Earth subject to major earthquakes. They feel that this year is one of the 64 was the last one with the big earthquake in Alaska. 71 is 7 years later. And there have been some terrible earthquakes this year, not all here in California, of course. But fascinating story. How do they measure that the Earth wobbles 6 inches a day? I mean, how would they measure that? And wobbles as much as 72 feet over a 14-month period. Maybe they do have finally the reason for the earthquakes. There's a story on page 13 that is so infuriating I hardly even dare read it to you. A Senate witness said Monday he saw more than 560 rare eagles killed by shotgun from airplanes last winter in Wyoming. The ranchers were paying $80 a day to the hunters, or $25 per eagle. And they shot so many eagles, they had a whole haystack of dead eagles. Ready for that? Terrible. Oh, here's a story about that fountain in Griffith Park. You know, right at Ferndale, at the entrance to Ferndale. And people line up there to get water. And it's a fascinating story because for 12 years now, the water hasn't come from a natural spring. It's regular city water. There's some springs in the park, and it used to be spring water, but now it's regular water treated with chlorine, and yet people fill up bottles, and they claim it does just wonders for them. Art Buchwald has a fascinating column, All You Wanted to Know About Communist China. Read it. It's kind of a serious column for Buchwald. He says, "I suppose it's a small price to pay for a free press, but I'm warning the media right now, there are just so many pictures of the Great Wall that the American people can take, and the main danger of this is that we may all turn off China before Mr. Nixon even gets there." And I got to read you this thing. I'm hurrying. I got to read you this thing about Jim Murray's column. He says you might expect when Americans hit the moon, the first thing they would bring along is an automobile. The Germans would have brought a cannon. The Russians would have brought a slave labor camp. The French a mistress. The Italians a microphone. The Irish a bottle. The Hungarians a violin. The Chinese a flat iron. The English a butler. Texans an oil rig. And the Greeks a frying pan. He says it's not too surprising to Ralph Nader that the first lunar automobile turned out to be a lemon. It was a steal at $36 million, but the wheels wouldn't work. He says he thinks the horn and the dashboard clock and the radio didn't work either. And he says, talk about depreciation. This car depreciated at $10 million a day. Typically, the Americans abandon it on the highway. And that's our look at the news for Tuesday, August 3.
Wake up, Morris. Oh, I don't look so grumpy.
Well, go jostle somebody else.
Time for din-din.
Time for my finicky act.
It's nine lives.
Uh-oh, nine lives.
Tuna, liver, how about seafood platter?
Seafood platter with shrimp.
Nine lives, the nutritious foods cats really like, even Morris.
There'll be no finicky act today.
Two soap operas are the last daytime serials to be broadcast live. The story in the new issue of TV Guide.
I thought you were going to surprise your mom and cook dinner.
Oh, I was, Papa. But it turned out to be a bad day for cooking.
Oh?
Well, first I put the salt in the pepper shaker. Then I dialed the wrong number. Points!
Folks like my Kentucky Fried Chicken so much, they think up excuses not to cook. My secret recipe makes it so finger-licking good that it's hard to think of cooking or eating anything else.
And I couldn't find my diary either.
But for chicken's sake, I hope you never do.
Come on over and visit the Colonel.
Come this September, this is a place to be.
Strange Love.
Or How I Learned to Stop Worrying and
Love the Bomb.
Cartoon.
Latest and greatest movies, this is the place to be this fall, the 6:30 movie on Channel 7.
You decide.
season, the ABC Sunday Night Movie presents some of the most outstanding feature films in motion picture history. The Longest Day. Von Ryan's Express. For Love of Ivy. Cleopatra. And that's just the beginning. El Dorado. Love. Murderer's Row. A Lovely Way to Die. The Silencers. Lord Jim. Three on a Couch. Moratori. Day of the Evil Gun. This season, the ABC Sunday Night Movie.
Thursday morning, see live coverage of Al Warden's spacewalk starting at 8:30 here on ABC.
Master Charge. It cuts the whole country down to traveling size. You can charge airplane tickets. You can travel across the USA because Master Charge is good for rent-a-cars, hotels, motels, restaurants, and gasoline. You can take little hops or long leaps with Master Charge. It cuts the whole country down to traveling size, except it all over town, all over America.
Goodbye, sugar. It was great fun, but it was just one of those things.
The Coca-Cola Company introduces Tab without sugar. Just one calorie in 6 ounces. You know, there are diet colas with sugar, but there's no sugar in Tab. Goodbye, sugar.
Bye.
Hello, sugar-free Tab.
This is Your Life, Carol Channing, Thursday night.
The Movie of the Week. ABC presents an original motion picture produced especially for the Movie of the Week. Tonight on the Movie of the Week.
What is it?
Home. Dad, I've been living in your world all my life. Why don't you try mine for a while? Can you dig it?
Carl Betts.
You think I couldn't cut it?
Vera Miles.
No.
Hey, does anybody have any idea where we're going?
In Search of America.
I love it!
ABC presents the Movie of the Week.
Just a little too much high karate, and your girl can get in your hair. That's why we put instructions on self-defense in every package. High karate after shave and cologne. Be careful how you use it.
Ever wonder what those guys say at a time like this?
My arm's killing me today.
Bengay. For tired arms, sore muscles, new confidence. Bengay, the great reliever.
Join us again tomorrow for another half hour of drama on As the World Turns.
Some grass.
Yeah?
And no one's home at my house. Want to come over and smoke?
Nah. It's great stuff. We'll really get high.
Yeah.
Nah, just don't want to.
I said no one's home.
So why be so sneaky?
Because it's against the law, stupid.
I'm stupid? Why do you think they call it dope?